Hello guys, good day everyone. So as per request of the people or the followers of my FB page, PLC Basic Tutorial, I will show you again how to create from scratch, how to create a program to PLC, how to upload, how to configure hardware. So I will show you how to make a new program. Okay guys, from the start I will show you. So first you need to have a Simatic Manager S7 for S7300, and then we will open this. Okay, so we have S7300 here. So we have empty here now. We have empty. By the way, I have a PLC here, S7300. This is 31366CF03. Okay, so from this empty, we will create a new program. So I will show you one by one. So please be listen carefully and watch how to create a new. Okay guys, so we will start here. You see, new project, we will open this one. Okay, select this one, and then it will be open. And then put your name here, what you like to name. Okay, I will put it PLC trial. I will name it PLC trial. And then where you want to put, so I will put it in my folder JKulit. Okay, so and then press OK. So I have here guys, now I will maximize this one. So we have our blank program here. See, PLC trial. Okay, see, PLC trial. So after that, go here, MPI, double press, double click. It will open like this. Okay, so we will configure our hardware here. Okay guys, so after that, you will go here, station. So open station, and then double click Simatic 300. Okay, so the Simatic 300 is already here. Okay, after that, double click again the Simatic 300 to configure the hardware. Okay, press OK. So it's coming like this. It's empty. So first thing, you will go here in Simatic 300. Okay, open Simatic 300. So what will you do if this is empty? Okay, so go here. You need have a rack. Okay, you will open rack, and then double click this rail. It's loading. Okay, so we have rail here now. Okay, we will make it longer. Okay, so we have a rail, and then we will put now our CPU. Okay, or our power supply first, PS300. So we will get here. What you need, 10 amperes, no problem. So we have a power supply here in number 1, slot 1. So we have PS307, 10 amperes. Okay, then close this one. Next one, we need to get our CPU in number 3, slot number 3 is the CPU. Okay, we'll get here. So I have a 313C. So you see here, DP, 313C DP. I have my PLC here. This is my PLC guys. This is 313. So I will get a 313C2DP. Okay, I will open. And then here downside. Okay, second one, version 2.6. I had 2.6 guys. So double click. Okay. Oh, number 2, wait. It's only in number 2. Sorry. Slot number 2 for the CPU. Okay. Version 2.6. The number 3 is for the another one. So, it's loading, guys. So, this is our CPU. CPU 313C2DP. Okay? So, we have it there. So, in here, what will we need to put here in number 3? I will check. Okay. So, no problem. We cannot put in number 3. In rack number 3. So, we will jump to the number 4. The number 4, guys, is the input module. So, we will put a input module here in number 4. Okay, you must go here, SM300, open, and then you can put it here, digital input, if you like digital input. So I have here, guys, a 32 bit here, 32 bit, okay, input, and I have 32 bit output here, okay, DIDO. So first, I will put a digital input, DI 300, so 32, we will select 32 24 volts here, 32 24 volts, okay, so it's coming there, no? So the address of the digital input is from I0.0 to I3.7, okay, and then after that, in the slot number 5, we will get digital output. So you will go here, digital output. Okay, so we have 32 bit also, so we will get our 32 bit digital output. So we have here DO 24 volts, okay, 0.5 amperes, okay, double click. So the address is 4.0, output 4.0 to 7.7. So we have a output now, input and output. So we already completed here, no? This is the first step you need. And then you must go here, guys, save and compile to check if there is a something wrong in your hardware. So we will press this one. So it's configuring now. Okay, just loading. So, it's okay now. Okay, so save now, save. Okay, we have now our hardware, no? Okay, guys, you see it? Very simple how to create from empty, from the scratch, empty folder from our PLC, and then we will close it, guys. Okay, close this one. Okay, so we have already here our PLC. Okay, so we will open this one, our PLC trial. I will open this here, Simatic 300. Okay, CPU S7 program, open blocks, double click, see. It says OB1, so it is empty. There is no program here because this is from the scratch. So I will show you again. So how can we put a program now? So I will put you a simple program, guys. First, press right click, insert object, and then function. Okay? After function, this is FC1. See the name. So you must put here what you like to put in the symbolic name. I will put a control. Okay, then press okay. So we have already our FC1. So you can program now inside. All right. So we have empty. So I will create a start stop here. Okay, guys, start stop. So first I will put A normally open. I will assign A I 0.0 for the stop. Okay. Next I 0.1 for the start. So input 0.0, input 0.1. Okay. So I have here our push button 0.0 and 0.1. I have here a button. I already wire it. Just before. Okay. I will put coil. So the output we have is start from Q4.0. Okay. So we have Q4.0, and then after that, guys, we need to put a holding contact here. Okay. So this is the one we have a holding contact. Okay, guys. We have a holding contact there. Oh, I will not put there. Here, I will put in the purse. Okay. So put a normally open of the output for the holding contact. Q4.0. Okay, and then close bracket. Okay, save. Oh no, it cannot be download. Oh, downloaded. I will save it. But we cannot monitor it, guys. You know why? Because you need to go to the OB1. Okay? You must save it in the OB1. You must call it in OB1. We will open OB1. Okay? Name OB1. Okay, no problem. Okay. Watch my tutorial, guys. Listen carefully so you can understand and follow my tutorial. So we have a empty network here, no? So we will go here in FC blocks. Open FC blocks. Okay. So you see FC1 control. So double click this one. It came here. No? This is OB1. Acronym OB. The name of this OB1 is organization block. Okay, so save it, then download. Okay, so we download it, guys. No, after that, we will go to our blocks. We will download it in our PLC. Okay, so see, download. See, speak pass by application. One moment. You want to continue? Yes, continue, yes. So, all. We'll put it all. This is only for trial, guys, no? Okay. Do you want to load the system? Yes. Yes. Okay. Run, stop, okay? Yes. So, I already download it in our PLC. I already put it here. So I have open there. We have lights, no? So we will go to our control. We will open and monitor this one. So I created a simple stop start. So I will push the button, this one, the start, and this is the stop. So I will press this one, okay? See? It goes here and the motor is running now. Okay, guys, you see the output is here. Q4.0 is running now. So I will press the stop. You see it is stop now. No more light. So our program is being downloaded to our PLC. So that's very simple, guys, no? So you can add more if you want. Okay, guys, thank you so much for your time, for watching my video. Thank you so much. God bless to all.